into the story. Vishnukaka had invited the entire family for dinner. It was a lavish meal with many courses. Everyone ate their fill, enjoying each dish. After it was over, the children gathered around Kaka as he brought out his big box of paan. They loved watching Kaka choose and mix his ingredients to make delicious paans, which the grown-ups then ate with blissful looks on their faces. He explained to the children, a paan contains betel leaf, betel nut and lime, but we should use only so much of each ingredient. Only then will it taste good. All seven children wanted to try this experiment on their own. Some of them chewed on only the leaf, some on the nut, and others on the nut and leaf, or the leaf and only lime. It was true, when the three were not put together, the paan tasted horrible. In fact, Sharan vomited when he added more lime than necessary. Everyone made a bean line for the mirror to check if their tongues were red or not. Ajay was sitting and chatting with Sharan's mom and watching their antics. Then she called out to them and said, "Children, by this time you must all know that the leaf, nut or lime on their own taste very bad. Even if you put just two together, it is no good. Only when you add the three in a perfect combination can a paan be eaten. And that's when you get that red color in the mouth." "Why is that, Ajji? Is there any special meaning?" Then Ajji replied, "Yes, there is a special meaning, and I'll tell you the story which I first heard from my grandmother." Then Ajji started narrating the story which he heard from his grandmother. Once upon a time, there were two brothers, Banu and Veer. Their parents died when they were young, and Banu brought up his younger brother with a lot of love and care. When Banu was old enough, he married Bharati. She was a gentle, loving person and looked after Veer with as much love as her husband. When Veer was about 20 years of age, he heard that their king was looking for soldiers to join his army, as there was going to be a war. Veer decided to join the army. Oh, how much his brother and sister-in-law cried and pleaded, telling him to remain at home with them. They could not bear the thought of the boy they had brought up with so much affection going so far away from them. But Veer insisted on becoming a soldier, so they let him go away with a heavy heart and tears in their eyes. For many days, there was no news of Veer. The king went to war, vanquished his enemy and returned. The soldiers who went with him also came back home. But of Veer, there was no sign. Day after day, his brother and sister-in-law watched out for him, hoping to see him come walking down the road back home. But there was no one. Then one day, a group of soldiers passed through their village, returning home from the war. Banu called out to them and asked about his brother. "Veeru, oh yes, so sad. He died, you know, in the battlefield," said one, shaking his head. No, he was injured and he recovered. "Did he not come home?" said another. "He was on his way home when he fell ill," informed a third. On hearing these awful tidings, Banu was deeply saddened. He decided he could not live at home waiting for his dear little brother to return. He would go and look for him. When he told his wife, Bharati too decided to go with him. Together, they set off one day to look for the missing Veer and bring him home. They decided to go to the site of the king's big battle, where Veer was last seen by his companions. This place was far away and they had to travel through forests and valleys and mountains and deserts. The two walked and walked over many miles, but poor Bharati was not strong enough. One day, after traveling through a thick forest, they reached a little hamlet. Bharati sat down, exhausted. Then to Banu's great horror, she died out of sheer exhaustion. Unable to bear his grief, Banu too died immediately. Over many years, at the place where the couple had died, two trees grew. One was a tall tree and the other a creeper that hugged the tree. It was as if Bharati and Bhanu were together even in death. Meanwhile, Veer, the brother they had loved so deeply, was not really dead. He had got terribly wounded in the war and spent many years recovering from his injuries in a little village far away from home. When he finally recovered, he came back as fast as he could to his old house, knowing how anxious his family would be for him. But imagine his surprise when he found the house locked and bolted, abandoned for many years. Slowly the neighbors gathered around and told him how Bhanu had decided to go looking for his lost brother. That night, Veer cried many bitter tears. How could he find his beloved brother and sister-in-law now? Where were they? By the time morning dawned, he had made up his mind. He would try and go to the way they had travelled and find them. Immediately he set off. Veer was a soldier, but he had only lately recovered from many wounds and was not too strong. It took him many days to walk across the difficult land Bhanu and his wife had crossed. Then one day, near a forest, he came across a little shrine. The villagers told him the sad story of how the shrine came to be. Years ago, a couple had arrived at the spot, tired from days of walking. Legend had it that they were on the way looking for a long-lost brother. When the two died without fulfilling this wish, two wonderful plants unknown to anyone earlier had grown at the spot. The leaves and nuts from the trees were so sweet and refreshing that the villagers decided to build a small temple for the man and the woman at the place. Veer listened to the story with growing sorrow. He realized the couple they talked about was none other than his brother and his wife. Unable to bear the news, he turned into a statue of limestone. Do you know how they have all been remembered ever since? The tall tree grew nuts called areca nuts. The creeper's leaves were pan or betel leaves. And from the statue came the lime paste that is added to preparations of pan. And this is how this loving family came together even after death. Together they taught people the values of love, unity and loyalty. And when people chew pan, they remember this story. After completion of Ajji narrating the story, Sharon's mom was surprised to hear this story. "Really, Ajji?" she said. "Even I was not aware why these three ingredients are always used to make a pan. I too will come to listen to your stories from now." Ajji nodded, then she added with that glint in her eyes, "Chewing pan is not good for your teeth. Everyone of you go to brush your teeth."